Hi. Quickly, before Miss Coffee Bean comes, if you already watched our video about the Charformer, go away. There's nothing you can see here. Okay. Here she comes. Hi, what is tokenization? You know, that line of code you use from Hugging Face Transformers and never care about. In today's video, we will see how this works. Tokenization is that part in pre-processing that is done to text before throwing it into your favorite language model, say BERT. It is a pre-processing step, so it is independent of the later training process, but it's crucial for most transformers. Without tokenization, each word of the English vocabulary would have to be assigned a unique vector on the input side, and when predicting the masked word in the output, the choice would have to consider the whole vocabulary. And if you believe that the English vocabulary that one can find in a dictionary is already huge, think about how it can grow even faster with all words that are not in a dictionary, like compound words created on the fly by someone as a stylistic figure, or all possible typos, right? A mistyped word is also a word and should have a way to be processed by a language model. This is where tokenization comes in to at least partially solve this problem by creating a smaller vocabulary of word building blocks. This hopes to cover as much of the dictionary as possible, including unexpected words. Therefore, tokenizers first segment the sentence into words, harder for some languages than for others. I'm looking at you, Chinese, Thai, and Korean, because you do not have white space separation. Then the words are parsed into subwords, so that even though supposedly the dictionary does not have the word pre-processing in it, and therefore no vector representation to associate with it, the tokenizer can divide the word into pre and processing, supposing that pre and processing are already in the vocabulary and have a vector association. And this works great in very regular kinds of words that can be decomposed into known blocks, but does not solve the problem of noisy text, full of typos where the possibilities of mistyping are so many that a fallback to a known subword is either impossible or leads to misunderstandings. So tokenization being so rigid can become a problem, an even bigger one when working with multiple languages where the out-of-vocabulary problem becomes even greater with every additional language the model has to handle. Even more, the downside of tokenization is that on downstream applications, you are kind of forced to use the same tokenizer as the model was trained with, because the trained model is very much dependent on the tokenization it is used to. Even though your task might benefit from other tokenizations, you now must stick with the initial ones. No, you're not allowed to see other tokenizers, Miss Coffee Bean. Well, we hope that we could make the purpose and inner workings of tokenization now clearer to you. Do not forget to like and subscribe. Okay, bye. Hey, so it's me again. As you have perhaps already noticed, this is a partial re-upload of the explanation of tokenization we did already in the Charformer video. We think we did quite an okay job at explaining it there, very general, but that general explanation is not search engine retrievable if you search just by tokenization. So through this video, we just wanted to resurface that explanation a little bit. And that was it. Okay, how does Miss Coffee Bean usually end these videos? Okay, bye!